Guys, it's Daniel Murphy. Hope all is well with everybody out there. Christmas is coming. Listen, there's a lot of debate about a couple issues. Number one is the tapered hinge. We're definitely going to use that. We got a side-leaning oak. Got a 24-inch bar here on a 461. That's a little short for the hinge I want to leave. The fact that it's side-leaning, I'm trying to get a good amount of hinge involved. The shallower I cut that notch, the less hinge I'm going to have. So when I go a little deeper, get a little longer on the hinge, which will help for fighting the side lean here. Probably not absolutely necessary because the top is out of this tree. There's not a huge amount of side lean, but I just like to throw everything in my favor. So turns out that the bar is short here for the hinge I want to leave. Now, how I'm going to handle that by doing a plate cut where it's an intentionally high bottom cut on the notch. So you can see here, I'm all the way in there, come around here. My bar is coming to about here, so it's going to be short. All right, I'm thinking this is even high here. I think this cut's going to have to be extended down here a little bit. Now, by making this first cut, the bottom cut, intentionally high, I'm going to get this piece out of here and I'll be able to see exactly where the tip of the bar is on the other side there. So let's take a look and see how that looks real quick. And it takes a few extra seconds than someone that can make a perfect cut like a West Coast follower, that just their job is to put trees on the ground all day. Our job today is to put this one tree on the ground. If it takes me an extra minute or two or 5 minutes or 15 minutes on a big tree, I'm okay with that. I just need that tree to make the lay here. So let's see what it looks like. Obviously not going to be the way I'm leaving the hinge. There's a big kerf cut through there. That's purpose, right? On purpose. But I can see exactly what's going on for the second cut. The floor cut's going to be a little bit lower. The other thing, I'm cutting this tree a little higher than I normally like. We have some decay, a little bad spot in here. So I'm trying to get above the decay. Let's see what this looks like here. Taking that first cut doesn't take long. And then if it helps you match that second cut or keeps you from having to walk around the side of the tree to make that second cut from over here, it actually saves time. Now let's take a real good close-up of this hinge here. Of the notch. It's going to be the front of the hinge there. It's not perfect, but by the time anything that's like a little bit of a kerf in there closes, it's not going to affect the fall. At that point, I'm going to make my lay. And it probably won't, there's going to be enough stretch in the hinge fibers that won't make a difference.